is discussing is on Eliana based data transmission in UWB transceivers. So as we go with basic thing with wireless sensor networks, we have n number of challenges and n number of things has to be satisfied from the user end and also from the network end. As we go with that, the first concern we do is with energy efficiency. And while designing with respect to the heterogeneous networks in a specific dynamic environment, the data transmission would be difficult because there will be n number of nodes, and with n number of nodes, everyone will be acting at the active rate. At that time, the data transmission would be greatest task. And in resolving this, what my proposed methodology is autonomic based learning in a MAC layer. See, whenever there is a fault node or is there any kind of fault occurrence in the entire network, the cluster or the sensor nodes always goes back to the application on the transport layer, and from there it will reroute or it will justify what kind of error or whether the retransmission of the packets as such is required. Therefore, why can't we do at the bottom of the network layer itself? So here the concept with learning the automatic based network architecture is actually with learns repeatedly from the previous occurrences and avoids the congestion. So the simulation results shows an increase in throughput and decrease in energy consumption. So these are the six topics I would like to discuss today: introduction, related work, implementation, simulation and performance evaluation, conclusion and references. So with the introduction, as we already said, the analysis and design for low cost integrated sensing, communicating and computing nodes are required. Then requires collaborative spacing, space time processing task is required. In related to the same, appropriate sensor technology has to be used, and specific communication range, there are chances of interfering leading to packet loss and need to be retransmitted. So the main motivation in this is how exactly we can do with the reliability in data transmission. Why the reliability that comes in data transmission is we are looking into UWB, which is of a shorter range communication, particularly it is used in body area networks. Then the contribution from my side is with learning based automatic network architecture, which provides a reliable communication that integrates UWB sensor network with complex dynamic environment at larger nodes between the nodes. So these are the related works I had referred, and come to a conclusion why I shouldn't do with cross layer design. Then my complete implementation starts with I am taking a large number of nodes in a speculated environment where the set the intermediate nodes with source and destination randomly. Then I will be find the probability of occurrence of each node within that route, then select the randomly distributed nodes. If the determine the probability of the selected path is done, then the transmission happens, and check for the fault in node if there is any fault node exists. If it is yes, then again I will be doing the probability of the selected path and I will reassign for the neighboring nodes. If it is no, then the complete process is happening with n number of iterations. There won't be much limitations over there. So the simulation parameters what I considered was time limited to 50 seconds, and generation of random numbers was selected to 5 terrain, and the dimension was varying between 1 kilometer to 800 meters, and the number of nodes were varied from 100 to 1000 nodes, and the placement were made as random, and for a particular dynamic environment the mobility was kept none, but the node used to move with the enough mobility. So the propagation limit was given with minus 111 decibels per decibels meter. Then propagation path loss was 2 ray, and noise figure was limited to 10 decibels. Temperature was set with 300 degrees Kelvin, and radio type is radio acoustic noise, and which is SNR bound, and the transmitted power was just 20 decibels meter. And the MAC protocol has with standards 802.11g, and architecture what we had used is learning automata based autonomic network architecture. So these are my performance analysis. As the energy consumption is concerned, compared to only the local automata without involving any autonomicity, my energy consumption was reduced by 10% compared to that of the previous LACAS environment, and the throughput was increased by 17% in LACAS UWB environment. And finally, what the conclusion I can give is, to achieve reliable communication between the nodes at larger rate can be justified, and the throughput and fault tolerance levels has to be optimized in dynamic environment containing large number of nodes, and provides a continuous communication even if the nodes are not in the communication range, availing the function of master or slave to the respective nodes. And finally, what we could understand is, it uses a cascode architecture for a UWB environment, and the performance results are compared through simulation, and is capable of effectively avoiding the congestion. Once the congestion is avoided, in turn I will be having a much packet delivery ratio, so giving me the consuming less amount of energy, and also the number of collision decreases at the intermediate nodes, thus increasing the throughput. So these are my references.